Hey everybody, welcome to a Dimir control video for channelfireball.com. This is standard 2022. This was a deck list that I got from Inside Esports Tournament. I don't want to mispronounce the name, but Tian Fa Moon. So I'm going to play some matches, or I guess it's best of one, if you want to call it a match or a game or whatever. I changed the sideboard a little bit because that was a best of three tournament. So basically, because I have the two copies of Divide by Zero, I just stacked the sideboard with learn cards. So we want to foretell Beyond, because we can play a blue land and then we can have up Sot coming plus Beyond. If we foretell Sot coming, we can't have up Beyond. Behold. I don't know why I always call it Beyond. Behold, excuse me. Might be playing a control mirror. I guess we'll see. All right, Covert Go Blue looks to be having mana issues. Do I want an Ice Tunnel? It's like not that bad, to be honest. I think I'll be greedy because I have another Behold. I think I'll just suspend nothing because we can't, if we suspend Behold, we can't leave up Sot coming. I'm hesitant to play Dishwari Disruption as a land because our opponent has had pretty extreme mana problems. Like, all we have to do is wait. If they don't draw lands, we get to get ahead just by mana advantage. So, like, if they have to start discarding to hand size, it's really hard to come back. I think we can probably just force through Professor Onyx here. Yeah, I mean, whatever. I don't blame them. They're just so far behind on mana. It's impossible to win control mirrors like that. I mean, I say impossible. It's exceedingly unlikely. I guess I was going to say maybe we should mulligan, but we have just Jawari Disruption to play as an island, so our hand is slow, and we have no card advantage, which are the drawbacks. I mean, this is a hand that could get run over by Mono Green. The Crippling Fear, that's actually pretty good. We can use that to get a land, although it's a bit slow, but like if we play Divide by Zero next turn, and then on the following turn we can play Environmental Sciences, I think that's what that one's called, and get another island and have up Sot coming. This card is pretty good against us. We may have to just divide it by zero at some point and then counter it on the way back down, but for now, we'll just play on. I think I'll just use the Crippling Fear now. because we get a 3-for-1 out of it. But this, even at level 3, is threatening, so... that's actually kind of a problem. I guess maybe I want to play Flunk. And maybe a bit of trouble because we're just going to get smacked. Like, weirdly, we kind of want them to be able to attack with that Faceless Haven, because we don't really want to get chunked after we play the Sweeper. Looks like they might have attacked with the other land, which I guess we'll have to kill that one. Let them attack, because then maybe they'll put their counter on the land or something. Did they put both on it? Yeah, okay, well, we'll poison the cup. I think we want exactly one land. But we're in bad shape against the Faceless Haven. Bad shape against that, too. If we play Blood on the Snow, we're going to lose to, like, any land or creature. I mean, could behold now, and then try to hit a removal spell. I think probably I'll try to behold into like a removal spell in a land, and then like if I get to, maybe I have a chance if I can divide, like if they maybe are too aggressive and I get to potentially divide by zero and play a mascot exhibition, maybe. I think we're dead because I can't figure out a way around it. Like, because they can put counters on the creatures and attack. I guess I'll just hope they make an error. But if they just put counters only on the wolves, I'm dead. Okay. If you all haven't had a chance yet to pick up your AFR cards or AFR product, head on over to channelfireball.com. Check it out. Also, if you haven't signed up for CFB Pro, it's a great time. There's a lot of standard 2022 content, as well as releases, set reviews, and things like that. So head on over to channelfireball.com and check it out. All right, flunk can sometimes be awkward early in the game, but I mean, with four land and a Graven Lore, they have a white black land. Okay, I'm gonna do this. With four land and a Graven Lore, we're probably doing fine. Okay. All right. Guess I'll continue to foretell. I mean, now I have both of these up next turn. Okay. Probably need to find a sweeper at some point. I can. Guess I have to do nothing because Flunk is just awkward against all the learn cards. All right, this stinks, but I'm gonna double flunk this because they don't have any cheap cards and they do have environmental sciences. So I don't really love our position, though. We have some chance. Or I need a land. I need to be able to cast this Graven Lore into like a sweeper or something. Sure. If they go for the expanded anatomy, I can probably just flunk whatever they put it on. Go for a Clarion Spirit. Maybe I should just counter it. Because, I mean, now if they play the Anatomy, I can still just kill whatever with the Flunk. So, definitely, we're in some trouble. I mean, cards in their hand don't do that much, but this one scries. I mean, they have two unknowns. They were land light for a while, so they could have an expensive card. We can't really beat an expensive card right now. If they have like, this doesn't kill us. All right. Maybe I'll have to get find a sweeper now if we don't die. We're going to be really behind the eight ball, though. We have Shadow's Verdict and Blood on the Snow and Crippling Fear that we can find off Graven Lore. Yep. I don't know if they'll have any way in their deck to do two damage to us directly. I kind of doubt it, but you never know. Okay, I guess we have to bottom everything because we just have to have a sweeper. Although I really would have liked Onyx, but... I guess we're dead. It's unfortunate. I don't know. We needed one of our sweepers in the top nine. I don't know what I'm hoping for, that they just don't attack. Okay. But I mean, I can't. This dies to just the flyer, so. Okay. Play the tunnel first. Turn two will probably foretell the behold, and then if we don't hit a land, maybe then we play just Jawari Disruption as a land. If we do hit a land, we still might. Yeah, so now our plan is just to race to five mana for the Shadow's Verdict. Okay. I'm going to play this tunnel. I want to be able to counter the Chariot. Sure. Alright, so we'll take the 7, we'll go to 11, then we'll play Shadow's Verdict, and seems like we'll be in okay shape. The worst thing is the Chariot, probably, because then the rest of our plays are pretty awkward, but they would need to draw a land, which I guess they did. Gnarled Professor, that's okay. They don't have any creature lands, so Professor Onyx minus is pretty good. Maybe they could play like an Old Growth Troll or something. Some people I've seen play that frog card. I'm just gonna take a land. Flunk this while they're tapped out. Now we can have a Baleful Mastery plus all the card draw. If they don't play anything with haste that we need to deal with right away, we get to use card draw. I don't know that Ranger class level 3 is going to be good enough to beat an Onyx, but I guess we'll see. I definitely don't want the lands. I definitely want the side coming. I think I'll just take the side coming. Alright, so spin or foretell this and this. So now we can cast these two, or if we don't need to cast either one, we can cast Baleful Mastery or Behold. Probably Mascot Exhibition. I don't know. Interesting that they didn't try to hit Onyx for one, because now I can minus. Right, I think I won't foretell the other one because now I can cast a side coming plus Graven Lore. Don't want any of these. All Storm Giants, not bad. I kind of want to divide by zero so I can bounce the Ranger class. It's really all they have going for them right now. Okay. I could bounce it and then counter it on the way back down. Yeah, good enough to keep. We've got the Behold. Behold is just a great card. I'm gonna have to probably cast it. If I don't draw a land, I'll have to cast it in our own main phase, the spell satchel. I've seen some people playing this. It's kind of a neat card. So just basically all lands to the top, everything else to the bottom at this point. Divide by zero is decent against this thing. It's a weird card. But a fine one. I'm just gonna play this. They're going to cast the card where they sacrifice a creature, draw two cards or whatever. Probably going to bounce the satchel at end of turn because I want to get environmental sciences. I'm in a little bit of trouble this game just because they're going to have so many cards. And like once this stuff gets dealt with, it's going to be pretty annoying. I'm gonna play Jawari Disruption, even though, just because I don't really want to play Behold here. Good chance I'll play another Divide by Zero. Now there's a great chance. I don't have anything for that, so guess I'll get an answer to it. Guess I do have Blood on the Snow. Maybe I should just slam Onyx. I will. Might be able to set it up in a way where you get one more snow land, and Blood on the Snow gets back the Onyx. Okay. I don't have any ways left to get rid of the satchel. I guess I'm just gonna play Blood on the Snow. I mean, I need to get rid of, clean up all this crap anyway. Yeah. Oh, it doesn't kill all of it, does it? Oh, that was really bad. I got confused as to what my card did. Okay, well, this is a problem now. That's okay. I'll play through it. I can just confront the past. All right, I will confront the past. The hell did this card they just cast do? Hold on, I can't see anything. Right, that's my card. Oh, so it copies it? Okay, I guess there's nothing I can. Oh, I see they're getting counters. Oh boy, I really am not. I guess now I can cast this and kill the planeswalkers, but I'm in some trouble because they're gonna probably then play creatures. Though I do have Gravenlore. I don't know. I don't really know what's going on that well in this game, it appears. Maybe I'm supposed to do nothing. I guess I am. I'm not going to counter Mascot Exhibition because my counter is too valuable and I just need to find like a Shadow's Verdict or whatever for that. Feel like I want the Saw It Coming. Kind of want the Behold, but I don't know that I can afford it. It's getting extremely greedy though. Taking it. It's extremely greedy, but it's unclear if I can win the game without it. Gotta discard this and a land. I don't know that I should care. Maybe I should, but about spell satchels. This is set up in a way where I can play Negate plus Grave and Lore. Should have tapped my mana. I guess I needed two black. Well, that's not good. I guess I have to kill creatures. Don't have to leave up Poison the Cup just because then I have up two counters. Alright. I have a chance here, I think. Maybe not a great one. Willful Mastery, the creature. Alright. Still in this mode where I can play Behold. I still think, like, some sweepers would be decent. Shadow's Verdict or whatever. Professor Onyx is going to get countered. Sure. Pretty sure I'm going to let that one happen. Could have considered playing a flunk in response, I guess. Okay, I think now I just need to find like a Shadow's Verdict. Blood on the Snow is actually probably pretty good. I also have Baleful Mastery in the deck. I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10, 11. So if I can play Behold the Multiverse plus Shadow's Verdict plus Negate. The problem is if I play Behold and miss, I have to kill the creatures, which is not good. But I still have Negate up for this to get back Onyx. I guess I'll just play Behold up. Okay. Okay, we appear to be alive. Drawing a card and losing one life is like fine. Okay, that's something to keep note of. They have 32 cards in their deck, we have 25. Our Liliana's gone. Blood on the snow, destroy all planeswalkers. Yep. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. I'm just going to die to Liliana, aren't I? Foolish. I was thinking, well, I probably lose anyway because I just get Liliana back, but maybe they wouldn't have had enough mana to kill me. Well, maybe they don't have a second spell they can cast. That doesn't... Oh, they're going to target their own creature or something. Maybe they're short black mana, I don't know. Well, I mean... Oh, because it copies. Fair enough. That was a cool deck. I never saw that kind of satchel deck before. If you'll check the video description, you can see a link to Ultimate Guards catalog if you want to head over there and check out what they've got. Lots of good accessories, sleeves, deck boxes, play mats. Things of that nature as we head back to Paper Magic. So please give them a look. I would appreciate it. And help support my content and stuff. So thank you very much. So 2-3 so far, not ideal. I haven't played that great in some of the games. Haven't played a ton with this deck so far. And definitely I've been surprised by some stuff our opponents have. Which is, well, you know, it's fine. It's kind of one of the fun things about a new format, to be honest. White-green. Okay, white-green is another deck I have not played a lot against. Ranger class I have played a lot against. I'm just going to foretell here, because I don't think I'll actually poison anything. Probably rather just play Crippling Fear. The Scry can also be valuable in this game. Yep. I was playing a white-blue control deck before they banned Book of Exalted Deeds. I was all ready to write about and stuff. That deck was much better against this kind of thing because it had the Devout Mastery, is it called? The Wrath that just blows everything up. All non-land permanents. Looks like I'm going to play Poison the Cup. If I play Poison the Cup... and maybe a counter. We'll see if they activate Ranger class. Okay. Monarch Aspirant. All right. Not sure if this is perfect, but without, I don't know, without the island, like I don't really want to counter this, even though, you know, it's just a 2-1, but they do have a lot going on, so I also don't want to get too low because they have creature lands. Probably the worst draw in the deck is another negate against this white green deck, but what are you going to do? All right, so I can't really do anything. I guess I'm just gonna play this to kill one Inkling token. Like if their play is just try to attack me with the lair and I draw blue, then I might be able to do something by making a wolf or dog. Like, I think it's totally reasonable for them to just go like, all right, attack you for 7. Then I have to draw an untapped blue mana. Then I have to make a dog. The dog has to live. If they play to the board, I probably can't win, no matter how I play the previous turn. But if I just pass and they activate this, I'm practically dead, so... Yeah, another swamp. Okay, I lose... All right, so 2 and 4 so far. I'll play one more. Definitely could have done better in a couple of the matches. That one, I don't think I could have done that much. Okay. Foretell that, because I'd rather cast that next turn or have the option to, I guess. Colossal Plow. Whenever Colossal Plow attacks, add 3 white and you gain 3 life. Crew 6, okay. I see, yeah. I don't know if there's a way to protect it for 1 white, but I hope not. Presumably they've got more vehicles in their deck. Top 4 cards of your library, you... Okay. Golem can attack unless. Okay. Sure. I have 8. Do I have close? I have 3. Now I have 4. I This can get cranked by Liliana. Guess I have to counter that also. I'm just going to make a 6-6. I don't know if there's going to be great ways for them to get through. If they have like Portable Hole plus Attack Faceless Haven or something, I'm not sure. They probably have Portable Hole in their deck because of the Smith. Okay, I guess that card's still legal. Alright, so... I think we're in fine shape here. I don't know though. Okay. Wow. Well, that went well. Yeah. Okay, well, our opponent didn't have the best turn of throwing all their cards in the graveyard for no gain. So 3-4 overall, not great. Whatever, it's a fun deck, it's a good deck. Like I said, I think probably that reflected on me, maybe. More so than the deck. Thank you all for watching. I'll be back with more 2022 content soon. I'll see you next time.